Somebody found God.
I found him.
In the valley.
Somebody found deliverance.
Way down.
In the valley.
Somebody found peace of
oh,
mind.
Lord, it's
in the valley.
Somebody found joy
divine.
It's in the valley.
Somebody found love.
Yeah.
This evening.
In the valley.
Somebody found hope this evening.
In the valley.
In the valley.
In the valley.
Hey everybody, thank you for joining me with another episode of Real Life, of the Real Life of the Real First Lady. My husband's going to join me after the commercial. We have a lot of things going on. I'm not sure how much to share, because if we tell you all of it, then you won't watch the show to see it. So, how are you doing? So we have, we still have a lot going on, but God is going to see us through it all. You know, we've been doing this by ourselves for so long. I guess when you've been in ministry, we traveled for years, evangelizing in ministry for years. And you see a lot of things. You see a lot of people, and you see a lot of things. So it's really hard to open up and let people in when you know, when you see shiesty people, like, you're like, really? So I just, you know, really want to encourage the First Ladies. It's going to get better. It's going to be all right. Even though I was having a day today, because I've learned how to encourage myself. Sometimes I go through stuff I don't even tell my husband. I just figured it out. I've learned how to encourage my own self in the Lord. And sometimes you need people to talk to, but a lot of times you're going to have to just go through it and do it by yourself. So we have some changes coming, some things going on, some big things going on that you guys are going to be able to experience with us and see. We had to sit down and have a meeting about our life. You know, being pastors and being First Ladies is not easy. It's not something that you should enter into lightly. It just is what it is, you know. And I told you guys I was on workman's comp because I injured myself in the job. So they sent me a letter. This isn't part of it, but they sent me a letter saying, if your doctor doesn't release you to come back to work, and if you don't get off of workman's comp, we're going to terminate you. I'm like, really? Who does that? So, that's all I can say is I could just shake my head on that one. But there's several other things that are going on that we have to deal with and address as women, men and women of God. You just have to address some stuff. I'm not sure what to say and what I can say and what I can't say. Maybe my husband will talk a little bit about what's going on after the commercial, but we got some stuff, and I want to be as transparent as possible without saying stuff to affect my family, because at the end of the day, when the cameras are off and you guys get through watching our show, we still have to live. So we have some things going on, and I thank God for my husband. I think through transition and all the things that we've been through, it caused us to become closer, because I've always been the type of person, I'll do it myself. And because my family's not close, I have a lot of sisters on my dad's side, and I have one brother and three sisters on my mom's side. One of my sisters is deceased, so that just leaves me one sister and one brother. And then on my dad's side, there's a bunch of them. But I only speak to one sister. And not by choice, but it's just who they are. You can't change people and make people be what they need to be. And one thing, now I'm going to get a little personal. Now, the sisters on my dad's side, I'm not close to at all. But, you know, it really gets me. And I'm a woman of God, and they say they're saved. How are you going to judge somebody else? Judge what they're doing, and you don't even talk to that person. So it took me a minute and a while to get over that, but I'm over it now. But how do you stick your nose in someone else's business and you don't have a clue to what's going on in their life? I know I'm just keeping it real because this show is going to get for real. It's going to get really real on our show. We're going to say things and expose things. It's going to be godly. But what you guys really want to say, we're going to show you guys. No, this is what it is. This is how it is. It's not a glamorous life, you know. And you have to fight harder than the people in the world because you are saved. So the enemy comes at you even harder. So you have to, like, double team the devil as a team. But that was one thing that got to me. And then another thing that got to me, a third party came to me. I'm not going to say who or what, but someone in my family didn't approve of my show, of the show that God blessed me with. And I'm like, who are you to approve or not approve anything? Who are you? It just, people are just going to be people no matter what. They don't speak to you. You don't talk to them. You don't nothing them. And then they're going to try to judge what God called you to do. I want to encourage everybody on here, do what God called you to do. Because no matter what you do, somebody's going to say something. We are going to be authentic and as real as possible on this show. As much as we can, like I said before, without affecting my immediate family. Because at the end of the day, this is who I roll with. So, you guys see my hair? You guys know that I'm doing the tailbone lift challenge. So I want to show you how fluffy and long it is. See that? That's because I put a wig on and I braid it. And when I take the wig off, I spray it with water. And also I take vitamins. You have to spray your hair with water and you can't touch it. So next I'm going to get me a long weave. I think I want to go long for a little while, but let me show you how long it is. So look carefully. So, and I got this towel around my neck because I have grease in my hair and I'm trying to get grease on my furniture. But here we go, guys. It's right. Oh my goodness. Right here. Let me see. Wait. It's right here. I didn't pull a lot and I don't straighten it because I don't want a lot of heat on it, but I was just feeling some kind of way today and I got tired of having the wig on my head, so I'm gonna wear it in a French bun and hopefully tomorrow we can go for a walk. Hopefully next week on next episode we can start talking about what's going on. Maybe or maybe not, we'll give you a little bit of time and you guys can just watch our life unfold. Well, we're going to go to a commercial break now. This is First Lady Allen. Once again, I want to welcome you into our home and into our life. And I'll see you after the commercial break. You have a great day. Bye-bye. Hi, this is Lady Allen of the Real Life of the Will First Lady with Living Witness TV. We would like to invite you to our opening service of Ancient of Days International Churches in Zanesville, Ohio. Our address is 3745 Pike,
West Pike
in Zanesville, Ohio. Our services start at 11 o'clock a.m. Come out and be a part of this mighty move of God. We'll have deliverance, healing. We also are a five-fold ministry. We look forward to seeing you on June 26th at 11 o'clock a.m. Come and be a part of the movement. God bless you. Hey guys, thank you for joining me. This is me and my girl Marlene.
Hey. of the real life of the real first lady. We just got out of this awesome women's conference.
Yeah, women's conference, Divine Kingdom Builders. And we had Miss High there from Dayton, Ohio.
That lady preached.
She did.
Do you
hear
Teresa
me? High.
Oh, hallelujah. I feel the anointing. Ha sha. Yeah. Thank you. And we had lunch. It was just really good. We had a good time.
Nice fellowship.
It was good getting out. This is my girl from work.
Hey.
Okay. So, how about they mail me my stuff? And usually my girl right here, when people like
get stuff mailed out, I'd be the one to do it. Yeah. But this one, they didn't even let me know about it.
You know, this is so shady. Shady Boots. Shady. They're from the Shady Boot Club.
Oh, yes.
So, because, you know, I kind of got a little lost in it. I'm just saying. You can't just do people wrong. And then they didn't want to let me get my stuff. But here's the good thing about it is that I had already gotten my stuff out.
That's right.
Before I left, because the Lord told me to get my stuff. We have to listen to, learn how to listen to the voice of the Lord. So I have peace with this whole situation. I'm good. I'm not stressed out anymore. The job was very stressful, guys. So she knows. I don't know. She's done it for like 10 years. I don't know.
Honey, it's the grace of God. Nothing but. He put me in a place where I just got a shield around me. Everybody tried to get rid of me too, Tammie. They try to get rid of me too, but God, that's all I gotta say.
And it's so crazy because they used to try to pit us against each other now that I'm not there. Like, somebody asked me to watch her, monitor her, like, tell them when she comes back from lunch and breaks. You know, I do want to encourage those of you who are in corporate America, you really have to pray to stay because it's no joke.
None.
So, they are very catty.
Yes.
They will set
small,
you up.
Very small.
And you're like, what in the world? Like, just do crazy stuff. Because their jobs are their God.
It
but
is.
We serve a bigger
Come
God.
Come on now.
We serve a bigger God.
That's why I lasted that long. Because God had a reason and a rhyme for me to make their money.
Come on.
Because I used it for His purpose. And He had a reason for me to be there. Or I wouldn't have been there that long. Trust me.
I miss my girl because we had good times. I think they got mad because we were close.
You know it.
So
there was too much power.
Yeah.
The enemy got shaky, scared in his boots.
I call her the beige girl. Look how light she is.
I am not
she
either.
Is. I call her beige. Like, I get super duper dark, but I love it.
Yeah.
I love my color because it hides all my spots.
Yes. You don't need no makeup after that.
Well, I still have to paint this barn, y'all.
Oh, no, girl, please.
I paint this barn, but yeah, we had such a good time. I will always, and we'll always stay in touch, and I will always,
I told her she better not forget me.
Absolutely not, but y'all know I can't tell y'all what's going on in my life. I can tell her, but I can't tell you guys. Because you guys have to watch it unfold. And so in the near future, I am going to be giving away hair products and other stuff.
Okay.
So we're going to have free giveaways. All but the right. only way that you're going to be able to get the product is that I'm going to give keywords. I think that's what I'm going to do in my show. And then the person that emails me or Facebooks me first will be the one that win the prize. Or I'll just put all you guys' names in a bucket and pull a name. But I'm going to be giving away some ear hair vitamins, and they make your hair grow really fast.
Ooh.
These vitamins are $48 a bottle.
Oh, I need some now.
Okay, so I'm not giving away cheap stuff.
All
so we're
right.
going to have giveaways. And so we're going to be giving away all kinds of stuff, but you guys, if you want to be part of it, you have to watch the show. Yes, you do. So I'm very excited. I feel my Holy Ghost, y'all.
All right.
So I'm very excited about what God is doing, and I'm very excited about the plans that He has for my family, because I know that his ways are not my ways. But let me tell you this. This is the crazy part. One day, because I would cover for her for her breaks. And so one day I'm sitting at her desk and we just eating. And I mean, just little snacks. We're not like having a whole meal. But you know, you know how you have little snacks at your desk. So we're kind of like having little snacks. Oh, this is perfect. Little snacks at her desk. And she says to me, she said, "You're not going to be here long." I said, "What are you talking about?" Because I move in the office of the prophetess, right? And so Marlene goes to me, it's just a gift that I have. I don't know. Just God shows me things. I said, in my head, I was like, I'm not going nowhere.
She kept saying that.
I sure did.
From day one. She kept saying that from day one. But when words come out of my mouth as a blurb, I know it's not for me. You know, because I didn't have time to mull over it, think about it, pray about it, and all that stuff. It's just how God uses me. It just comes right out without my help. How's that?
So I ponder that thing. Now, you know, my husband couldn't say that to me because it would have made me mad. So the week after that, I think it was maybe 2 weeks after that, the Lord said, "Go to your desk and clean out your desk and take everything home." And I'm thinking, I'm still not trying to receive what my girl said. I'm thinking, oh, well, I must be getting ready to remodel my desk. So I took everything home. And the next week, all H-E broke loose, okay?
The hockey sticks. Yes. Double hockey sticks.
Yes. Broke loose. Not only did the devil come after me, but he came after my girl. Mm-hmm. But it was because my season was up. You have to know what season you're in. Mm-hmm. You just have to know.
You know, and time and chance comes to us all. And God used purposeful things for her to give her time and chance. And, you know, we can't tell you all about it right now, but it'll come out in later on in her story. You know, purpose things he allowed to happen to give her time and chance. And it's just God. So I say, you know, when is it my turn, God? my turn.
One thing about God, though, he won't let you leave empty.
Amen.
When God's hands in it, you're going to leave with the goods, like the children of Israel.
Yes.
When he
feel that.
Come on. When he told them to come out of Egypt, they left loaded.
Wow. I like that sound. Looking so forward to that.
Come on.
Thank you, Jesus.
So, but Marlene, I just believe God put you there for people like me.
Yes.
For people that are coming through.
Through. Oh, I like that. Yeah. All of us, you know, it's okay. And I learned the Bible says to wear this world lightly. That's to wear everything lightly because he doesn't need us in lengthy times, different places. He needs us to be obedient more than anything else. And when we can let things go, he can put stuff back in our hands.
And I want to say this too before we go to a commercial break. Guys, quit being scared. I keep seeing all these prophetic words where people say, "I saw that God was going to blow up New York, or God's going to do this." He's going to do what he's going to do when he's going to do it. Mm-hmm. And he said he won't let nothing slip upon his people. So I don't care where you live.
Right.
If a tsunami is coming there, God is going to come to you and say, "Okay, get your kids, get your stuff, and go, because I'm fitting to tear this place up."
Come on.
So you need to be confident to know wherever God sends you, you can live there until he say move.
And amen. Come on with it. I received that, woman of God. That is the truth anyhow.
So I love you guys. And I'll see y'all after commercial.
Bye.
Ta-ta.
Hi, this is Lady Allen of Living Witness TV. I would like to invite you to watch our new show, The Real Life of the Real First Lady. It's no script, it's live, it's on the spot entertainment. I would like to welcome you into our home so you can see what it's really like to be a first lady in the 21st century. We look forward to seeing you. God bless you and have a great day.
Hey everyone, welcome back from the commercial. We are at the Speedway. Oh, there's a car behind you. We are at the a Speedway. He came and got me a Slurpee because Slurpees, 32-ounce Slurpees are 89 cents. And then if you swipe your Speedway card, you get enough points and you get free drinks and stuff. So I live for the free drinks and the free chips. So it is hot. I do not know. No, it's just me. I don't know how people live in an area where now he gonna pull off. Really? How do people live in areas where there's only one season? Lord Jesus, it is hot here today. I don't know what's the temperature? 97 degrees. 97 degrees now. There's a car in front of him. I talked to my mama, and my mama was like, it's 100 and something. So my mama, y'all pray for my mama. First Lady Allen's mom, y'all pray for my mama. I called her the other day, day before yesterday, and we was talking, and she said she fell in the bathtub, and so her head was hurting. And so I said, are you okay? She said, yeah, I'm okay. I said, okay. And she said, my head's hurting. I'm getting ready to lay down and take a nap. So I didn't think too much of it, but the Holy Ghost was unctioning me to really pray, and I didn't, like I should have, but from now on I will. And I said, and so I couldn't reach her yesterday. And I couldn't reach my sister because my family lives on the West Coast and my husband's family lives down south. We're the only ones that are like up north. I guess we're just renegades. It's just really hard to live close to your family. It sounds good, but I'm just going to be honest. I don't mind visiting, but I think it adds a different element when you live too close. What you think, babe?
Yeah.
When you live too close to your family, it's all good when you're there for a minute because they enjoy you. But when they start getting common with you, then the real person show up, because everybody always calls me and tells me about the drama. Well, because I'm not there, it don't bother me none. All I say is, I'm so glad I don't live close to y'all. But anyways, back to my mama. So I couldn't reach my sister and I couldn't reach my mama. So then I called her this morning. I said, Mommy, you okay? She said, I'm okay. I said, what's wrong? What happened? Turns out that she had a brain bleed. She fell in the tub. She said she took a nap and she said she wasn't feeling right. So she got up and took herself to the doctor. They kept her because her brain was bleeding. Really? So, you know, I've been talking to my husband about us. We plan on doing some things, and I want my mom to come live with us because, really? You go on and hit somebody with your new car, you hit that raggedy car, you're going to pay for it. So, you know, a brain bleed, Mommy, for real? What is wrong with these people? He in the middle of the street, mad, drunk. Because he wants to cross the street. Really, dude, for real.
It's Columbus, man. You get ran over.
You need to get in the sidewalk because these people out here, they're not gracious and they don't care. So back to my mama. So.
What are we eating?
I don't know, honey. You know, I had the food from the.
You know what? Y'all want fish?
I guess you can do fish. Cindy's tired of fish. I like it.
I got the fish with the bone in it. That good fish.
What kind of fish?
They're whitey with the bones.
Oh, so let me tell you this. It's been somewhat hard. I'm kind of used to him now, to acclimate to Southern food, because I lived in Washington, the northern, up northwest, up there where they eat salmon and pasta and stuff. So sometimes it makes my stomach hurt, but it's better now. But the event I went to today, I have a lot to say. So So when I went to the event today, my girlfriend bought my ticket. Y'all saw her, Marley. The ticket was like $45. So I just don't understand how come when you pay $45, you always get chicken.
It's just a one thing.
No, everywhere you go, any kind of big function you have, they always give you chicken.
Chicken.
It was baked chicken. It had like a maybe a tablespoon
of scalloped potatoes and under it. They gave you one carrot on the side, and they gave you one leaf of one broccoli leaf and one more little thing. I was like, for real?
Come on, guys.
They always give you chicken. I didn't eat it. I think Marlene ate the rest of it, but the lady preached really well, and it was nice.
Next time y'all be speaking.
And I did some footage, but I couldn't get enough footage to put it on the show. You know. So I said, okay, well, I put that footage on my Facebook page. But now you guys know that you can go on Pastor Tammie Allen. That's me and my husband's page. It says Pastor Tammie Allen, but it has a picture of my husband on there. And you can click on there and see shows. But those shows that you'll see will be after the show that comes on Living Witness. But you guys that want to be a part of the giveaways that I'm going to give, you have to go on Living Witness and watch that show. You can't watch the show on YouTube. We're going to be putting the show on YouTube too. You can't watch it on YouTube because it's not fair to the people that get on and watch the one on Living Witness. So if you want to be a part of the giveaway and win some free stuff, you cannot, I repeat and I reiterate, you cannot watch the show on Facebook. You can, but you're not going to win anything. You cannot watch the show on YouTube and expect to win. You have to go on Living Witness TV and watch the show. Follow the instructions. There will be a deadline to follow the instructions to win. And here's how I'm going to do this to make sure that everybody plays fair. I'm going to wait until I announce the winners of the giveaway before I upload the show on YouTube and or Facebook. So, what do you think about that? So, if you want to win some really nice things and get in on the giveaways, you have to watch the show on Living Witness. And you have to tell a friend.
How much?
I got about 2 minutes. Yeah, go up just a little bit. I'm thinking, I was trying to figure out a way to help people win some stuff. So I really want you guys to watch, and I really want you to win, and I really want to give some stuff away. I think it'd be really fun. So, you know, and tell your friends. I think I'm doing a giveaway too for the people who invite the most people to watch the show. I haven't found out what we're going to give away. And we'll do a giveaway for the other show too, Eternal Life TV. So my husband's on Eternal Life TV every Saturday from 3:30 to 4. So if you watch that show and you invite, I'm not sure how we're going to do it, but we're going to do giveaways off of that show too. So there's two ways that you can win, but you have to watch the show to win. If you don't watch the show, you're not going to win. And we'll just keep doing it until people get it. The only way to win is to watch the show, guys. You got to watch the show. And I'm really, you know, really?
I'm not even going to.
Shaba.
Ignorant by hand.
They need to hold. They need the Holy Ghost. They need Jesus. You people drive crazy. You know, you have to be sure enough saved to drive out here in Ohio. We're going down here to this park. It says illegal dumping. Who dumps stuff in a park? Really?
People from Columbus.
You really dumping stuff in the park?
People from Columbus do that.
Oh, wow. Who knew? Really? We've never been down. You ain't never been down here before.
Yes, I have.
When did you come down here, Sydney?
When there was a soccer place down here. And I went to that daycare over there, right by my school, my old school, bilingual academy. And they had a daycare over there. So we went on all these little.
You should come out here when we had the bubble.
I've never been out here. But anyways, guys, I hate it when people try to tell me that I've been somewhere and I know I didn't. I haven't been there. I've never been out here. But so this is the end of this episode. You guys make your day great. Have a great week. And next Monday night at 9:30 p.m.
can, we're going to start revealing to you guys things that are going on. Make sure you watch the show, because we're going to start having...
Ooh, they got porta potties.
Oh, my God. Jesus, take the wealth. They have porta potties. You guys have a great one.
Bye-bye.